As in the previous video, we are going to use the periodic table and electron distribution to understand the structure of water. Let's begin by looking up the hydrogen atom in the periodic table. From the periodic table, we can see that the atomic number for hydrogen is 1. This means that hydrogen has 1 positive charge in its nucleus and 1 negatively charged electron orbiting the nucleus. Because there is only 1 electron, it will go into the first electron shell. Recall from the previous video how many electrons are needed to fill the first electron shell. You are correct if you said 2. Based on what you now know about electron distribution, is the hydrogen atom stable or unstable? It is unstable because its valence or outermost electron shell is not filled to capacity with electrons. Hydrogen will either gain, lose, or share 1 electron to become stable. Next, we will look at the periodic table to find oxygen. From the periodic table, we can see that the atomic number for oxygen is 8. So we know that there are 8 electrons in a neutral atom of oxygen. We also know that 2 of the 8 electrons will go into the first electron shell, and the remaining 6 electrons will go into the second electron shell. The second shell is not filled to capacity and needs 2 more electrons in order for the oxygen atom to become stable. The oxygen atom will either gain or share 2 electrons to become stable. In the case of oxygen and hydrogen, electrons are shared to satisfy the needs of both atoms. When electrons are shared between 2 atoms, a strong covalent bond is formed. Oxygen needs 2 electrons to fill its valence electron shell, so it will share electrons with 2 hydrogen atoms to become stable. The hydrogen atoms, in return, will share 1 of the oxygen electrons to become stable. This sharing of electrons between 2 hydrogen atoms and 1 oxygen atom forms a water molecule as indicated by the formula H2O. When atoms share electrons to become stable, there is often an unequal sharing of electrons, such as the case with oxygen and hydrogen. Because oxygen has a much stronger electronegativity than hydrogen does, the oxygen atom tends to pull the shared negatively charged electrons away from the hydrogen atom and closer to the oxygen nucleus. So by pulling negative charge closer to itself, the oxygen atom becomes slightly negatively charged, and the hydrogen atom becomes slightly positively charged. This molecule is then classified as a polar, having opposite charges at opposite ends, covalent molecule. The polar nature of water is extremely important to understand, as it is this property that allows a water molecule to behave the way it does. As we know, opposite charges are attracted to each other, so the positively charged hydrogen atom in a water molecule allows it to attract the negatively charged oxygen atom of another water molecule some distance away, forming a weak hydrogen bond. Keep in mind that because hydrogen bonds are weak, they are constantly breaking and reforming, and this is what allows water to flow. Now that you have a good understanding of the structure of water, you need to know the functions of water. In the next video, concentrate on those functions involving the human body.